Welcome to Warn. Today's news is: should ADA push LCA Navy Mk.2 against in wishes, or focus on the AMCA? On December 2, 2016, the Chief of Naval Staff Admiral Sunil Lanba told the press that the Indian Navy is scouting for another carrier operations compatible fighter besides the Mk.29, since LCA Navy lacks the payload required to be effective when operating from a carrier. The present LCA Navy does not meet the carrier capability which is required by the Navy. We will continue to support the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, and Aeronautical Development Agency, ADA, in their efforts to develop a carrier-based fighter aircraft. At the same time, we will seek aircraft elsewhere which can operate on the aircraft carrier, said Admiral Lanba. On January 24, 2017, the Indian Navy went ahead and released a RFI for procurement of approximately 57 multi-role carrier-borne fighters, MRCBF, for aircraft carriers of the Indian Navy, in. However, speaking to the press in February 2017, ADA Director Commodore C.D. Balaji, retired, said that the Navy Chief's December remark that the LCA Navy lacked adequate payload was restricted to LCA Navy Mark I. We knew, it was a heavier platform up front and it was basically a technology demonstrator and that is how it is intended, he said. Recalling the development testing underway since 2016, Balaji said, "We will convert this project into a product and that will happen once we do an arrested recovery, by mid of this year. The moment we do that we will carry the learning into Mark II which has already been designed." Clearly, the IN and ADA are not on the same page on the future of LCA Navy. The Navy wants to support LCA Navy as a technology development project, but ADA wants to see LCA Navy Mk.2 operationally embarked on IN aircraft carriers. ADA is reported to have vigorously lobbied with Room Manohar Parrikar to keep the LCA Navy Mk.2 project alive. ADA's desire is well-intentioned and widely supported by defense enthusiasts who believe that in order to become a great power, India must equip its forces with homemade weapons systems. However, ADA's attempt to arm-twist the IN through the room to eventually accept LCA Navy Mk.2 for embarkation makes little sense because despite a more powerful engine, LCA Mk2 SF414 has 10% greater thrust than the Mk1 SF404 engine, an optimized design, LCA Navy Mk2 will fall woefully short of IN requirements specified in its MRCBF RFI. LCA Navy Mk2 limitations, ADA's aggressive plugging of LCA Navy Mk2 suggests that the Mk2 is as capable as the MRCBF that the Navy is seeking. This is far from the truth. The extra thrust of the F414 engine would make the LCA Navy Mk2 more maneuverable but will not significantly increase its weapon load, which the IN considers inadequate. The extra thrust would come at the cost of higher fuel consumption, particularly close to max power setting, negating some of the benefits accruing from the 700-liter extra fuel that the Mk2 would carry. LCA Navy Mk2 will be a more capable air defense, AD, fighter than the Mk1 but will continue to lack credibility as a strike aircraft. Its range and weapon load carrying capacity would be limited even when operating from 3000M runways, let alone when conducting STOBAR operations from a 200M carrier deck. It's worth noting that the ADA itself plugs LCA Navy Mk2 as an AD fighter that would provide cover to a carrier group against fighter and cruise missile threats, not as a strike fighter. Scale models of LCA Navy Mk2 displayed at Aero India 2015 and Aero India 2017 were shown carrying just 4 air-to-air missiles, 2 on each wing, with a center-line drop tank. Ironically, the NRFI defines operationally clean configuration, OCC, for the MRCBF to imply that it's carrying 4 beyond visual range, BVR, missiles and 2 all-aspect air-to-air missiles, A4M. A total of 6 missiles, 2 more than the LCA Navy Mk2 would carry. Understanding IN requirement, Carrier groups are primarily strike groups, capable of delivering sustained firepower while operating at considerable distance from home shores. Typically, an aircraft carrier embarks only one fighter type to minimize logistics and maintenance overheads. The primary role of the embarked fighter is strike, so it must feature good weapon load and range. Since strike missions often require escort fighters and escort jammers, embarked fighters must also be capable of undertaking these roles. An embarked multi-role fighter allows mission planners to change the force mix, strike, escorts, jammer, based on how heavily adversary airspace is contested. The single embarked aircraft type is reconfigured for its assigned task. The USF/A, 18E/F, the French Rafale AM, and the Chinese J-11 are examples reconfigurable, multi-role carrier-borne fighters with good weapon load and range. The AMCA MRCBF, multi-role carrier-borne fighter, and the LCA Navy Mk.2's credentials as a multi-role fighter are weak. It would not be a good idea to embark LCA Navy Mk.2 aircraft on INS Vikramaditya or INS Vikrant alongside MiG-29KS, as ADA seems to suggest in its brochures and presentations. Having two fighter types on board would dramatically push up maintenance and logistics infrastructure requirements. More importantly, it would constrain mission planners, deprive them of the flexibility in selecting force mix. Mission force mix would become dependent on embarked force mix. For example, when operating in uncontested airspace, LCA Navy Mk2S would have little to do. The USN does not embark two fighter types on its supercarriers capable of hosting 60 fighters. In carriers are much smaller and embark around 20 fighters. Operating constraints will become severe. With 60% serviceability and even split of embarked types, INS Vikramaditya would be able to field just 6 MiG-29KS and 6 LCA Navy Mk2S at a time, hardly a credible strike force. Other RFI shortfalls, besides limited range and weapon load, LCA Navy Mk2 would fall short on many other requirements specified in the Navy RFI. Radar and EW suite, the RFI specifies a radar capable of engaging airborne and surface target, preferably in an interleaved mode. The aircraft should be equipped with a radar warning receiver, RWR, capable cueing an onboard airborne self-protection jammer, ASPJ, countermeasures dispensing suite, CMDS, missile approach warning system, MAWS, and towed decoy for handling threats. Interchangeability/modularity, the Navy RFI also stipulates high degree of interchangeability/modularity, all major airframes components/parts/panels, sub-assemblies, including the canopy should be fully interchangeable between aircraft. Hot and cold engine sections should be swappable. It should be possible to change the engine of an aircraft on the carrier itself. These requirements are easily understood considering that an aircraft carrier could be operating hundreds of miles from home shores. Interchangeability allows recourse to cannibalization to keep more aircraft airworthy. To achieve interchangeability, ADA as the design agency and HAL as the production agency would need to achieve better design and production standards. Conclusion: clearly, when drafting the RFI, the IN was visualizing Chinese carriers and nuclear submarines in the Indian Oceans, perhaps adversary beachheads on several Andaman and Nicobar group islands. The Navy was probably thinking Super Hornet and Rafale AM, both twin-engined medium fighters. Competing against the Super Hornet, the LCA Navy Mk2 with just one of the two engines fitted on the U.S. Navy fighter would be clearly out of league. LCA Navy equipped in carriers aren't going to be enough to deter planned forays into the Indian Ocean, so should the IN still procure them to help India achieve self-sufficiency in arms production? Rather than pushing the LCA Navy Mk2 as the right MRCBF for the IN, ADA would better serve the nation's interest by focusing on AMCA development. ADA certainly doesn't have the infrastructure and talent to pursue both projects simultaneously. but ATA should continue to pursue LCA Navy as a technology demonstrator, something the Navy wants it to do. After ATA masters arrested landing, as it plans to do later this year, the agency should pursue auto landing on deck and other relevant technologies, so that when the AMCA project gets a green light, ATA has all that it needs to develop the AMCA naval variant. Thanks for watching. Please like and share. Please comment your opinion for this news. Press subscribe button for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, WARN.